It's easy to go the way of least resistance. But when you are in the place of the wilderness, just know that when you go through your wilderness experience, God is there with you. There's some things you need to know about when you're in your wilderness. Number one, you need to be mindful of the fact that God is in control. I said, God is in control. He was led by the Spirit. That wasn't something he done on his own. He was led by the Spirit. Again, most people think the Spirit leads them to some nice, quiet, calm place. No. Sometimes the Spirit often leads you straight into conflict. But you got to know one thing, God is in control. God has a way in the wilderness experience to weed things out of your life. The things God has to get rid of, and he has to get you in the wilderness to get rid of them. There are some things you think you have, but God says, no, you don't need that. There's some people you think you need, and God has to send you in the wilderness to realize you don't need them. And the wilderness, rest assured, God is in control. God's hand is on the thermostat. There's a difference between the thermostat and the thermometer. God has his hand on the thermostat. He can turn it up when he wants to, and he turns it down when it gets good and ready. You ain't in control of that. Nothing you can do about that. But when God gets ready, you can hear me today because somebody don't get ready. Secondly, the wilderness steals your character. When I first started preaching, folks don't say a lot of negative things about me. They still say some things about me now, but it used to bother me at first. But a strange thing happened. After my wilderness experience, I couldn't care what they said. Amen. I don't care what they're talking about. I tell them, you can say what you want, but you tell my name right. Amen. It don't matter. When you go through your wilderness, it strengthens you. It encourages you. Help us, you. It gives you the courage to stand in spite of whatever. You better be standing. God builds your gap in the wilderness. Scripture says Jesus set his face towards Jerusalem. He could have never done that if he not gone through this experience. And so God gives you the courage. He gives you the strength to face whatever comes your way. That's basically. Go back to God. See, God in his own time will let you come out of the wilderness. You won't hear no voice. You won't see no visions. You won't have no dreams. But I guarantee you something. When you come out, you're going to have something to say. You're going to have something to say. When Jesus came out of the wilderness, Chapter 5 through 7, he starts talking. He starts preaching. Look like he can't stop. Chapter 5, he's preaching. Chapter 6, he's preaching. Chapter 7, he's preaching. You don't have nothing to say until after you come out of your wilderness experience. That's why Jesus told Peter, he said, look, because the devil is looking for you. He desires to sift you as wheat. He said, but listen, Peter, I'm praying for you. That when you are converted, when you come out, and when I bring you out, strengthen your brother and tell somebody about the goodness of Jesus. And tell somebody about all that he's done for you. Jesus is blessed of the Lord in the Spirit. You don't talk like that unless you're going through something. Not just other people, they yell and they say, you don't know. You don't make a way. You don't make a way. You don't make a way. The songwriter said, he cares you. What no other power can do. And when the Lord has brought you out, you're able to tell somebody. When the Lord has laid you down and enabled you to walk up, you're able to tell somebody. You're able to tell somebody, I'm seeing some lightning flashes. So somebody got to tell me about that. I'm seeing it for myself. But I've heard the thunder roll. It's stolen in some time. But I've felt this break of fashion, scattering about, trying to cover my soul, but I heard the voice of Jesus telling me still, but I don't.
And I see.
Hallelujah.
The healing.
Yes.
And I see.
Hallelujah.
So.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.